Calvary Presbyterian Church. My name is Victor Floyd. I'm the Minister for Spiritual Care. And on behalf of the pastoral staff and our music ministry, welcome to this service in celebration and observance of Ash Wednesday. No matter who you are, no matter where you are on life's journey, may you always be welcome in God's house. If you're here for the first or second time, a special welcome to you. If we have an email list, if you would like to sign up, please ask any staff member and we can get you signed up on Calvary's weekly email list. A special greeting to our Facebook friends. Some portions of this service will be shown on Facebook later in the week. If you have a cell phone or some device that makes noise, please silence it at this time. And also know that a big special thank you I want to say to our ushers, Kristen Nesbitt, Lois Dress, and Jamia Conrad. They will be helping us come forward during the composition of ashes and also collecting a free will offering in the entryway as you exit tonight. Another big special thank you to our director of music, Michael Conway, and to the chapel choir. This is a choir that rehearses separately from our regular Sunday morning choir. And your commitment of time and energy and creativity is not lost on me. Thank you for all the extra work you put in. Later in the service, you'll be invited to speak your prayers aloud to God as witnessed by this community. You may also request prayer through the confidential prayer box located in the entryway, the narthex. The deacons and pastors pray with these requests every week. Lent is a somber season of prayer and reflection. For some, it's a time to give up chocolate. For others, they take Mourning instead of driving their car. And yet for others, it's a return to our New Year's resolutions if we can remember them. This Lent, you are invited to give up a little of your time and join a Lenten Bible study. There will be forms available after the service. We will be studying the Book of Joy. It's a conversation between Desmond Tutu and Archbishop Desmond Tutu and the Dalai Lama. Fascinating book. We're just studying the last part in conversation with the lectionary biblical readings for each week. And somebody gave me this, and I just wanted to pass it along because I feel that we need this. There's a website called Data Detox. And you may go to datadetoxkit.org to get yours. I'll have it out in the entryway also after the service. Just ways you can lessen the strain that your smartphone makes of you. Let's take a deep breath and arrive in this place. As this hour wends on, when your thoughts wander, and they will, just go back to your breath, try to be present, and listen for what God has to say.
Words of Jesus. Come to me, all you that are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty.
Thank you.
Psalm 51 from the Inclusive Bible Translation. Oh God, have mercy on me. Because of your love and your great compassion, wipe away my fault. Wash me clean of my guilt. Purify me of my sin. I am aware of my fault and have my sin constantly in mind. I sinned against you alone and did what is evil in your sight. You are just when you pass sentence on me, blameless when you give judgment. I was born in sin, conceived in sin, yet you want truth to live in my innermost being. Teach me your wisdom. Purify me with hyssop until I am clean. Wash me until I am purer than new fallen snow. Instill some joy and gladness into me. Let the bones you have crushed rejoice again. Turn your face from my sins and wipe out all my guilt. O God, create a clean heart in me. Put into me a new and steadfast spirit. Do not banish me from your presence. Do not deprive me of your Holy Spirit. Be my Savior again. Renew my joy. Keep my spirit steady and willing. And I will teach transgressors your way and sinners will return to you. Save me from bloodshed, O God, God of my salvation. And my tongue will acclaim your justice. Open my lips, Adonai, and my mouth will declare your praise. Sacrifice gives you no pleasure. Were I to present a burnt offering, you would not have it. My sacrifice, O God, is a broken spirit. You will not scorn this crushed and broken heart. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.
If Lent is such a somber season, why on earth would we be called to practice humor? On the second Sunday of Lent, that is a week from this Sunday, Cal Chin will tell you why. The following reading from Matthew's Gospel, these words of Jesus seem to be calling us to not take ourselves so seriously. Beware of practicing your piety before others in order to be seen by them, for then you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, don't be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Abba God who is in secret. And God who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you fast, don't look so dismal like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces so as to show others that they are fasting. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may be seen not by others, but by God, who is in secret. And your God who sees in secret will reward you. This is the word of the Lord.
For help, and you have healed me. O Lord, gone down to the pit. Sing praises to the Lord, O you God's faithful ones, and give thanks to God's holy name. For God's anger is but for a moment, God's favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may linger for the night, but joy comes with the morning. As for me, I said in my prosperity, I shall never be moved. By your favor, O Lord, you have established me as a strong mountain. In your face, I was dismayed. To you, O Lord, I cried, and to the Lord I made supplication. What profit is there in my death if I go down to the pit? Will the dust praise you? Will it tell of your faithfulness? O hear, O Lord, and be gracious to me. O Lord, be my helper. You have turned my mourning into dancing. You have taken off my sackcloth and clothed me with joy, so that my soul may praise you and not be silent. O Lord my God, I will give thanks to you forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Quite unceremoniously by the God is truth. that in this world, joy does not come without suffering.
Amen.
In this world, death is part of everyday life. When I visit people in hospitals, especially those in intensive care units, there it is, the truth, hanging in the air like a neon sign. The wheezing of breathing machines, the unfeeling music of alarms, singing out for a replenished IV drip, a recalibrated level of life-giving oxygen. The names of close family are scrawled on a whiteboard. The sounds and the smells of human bodies, mortal bodies, a little dustier for wear, returning to the dust, the terminus of this body's worldly sojourn. On Ash Wednesday, we paint our foreheads with the dust to remind us of our mortality. And in the words of Jesus, when you go home, wash your face. Previous generations of Christians did not need reminding about mortality. Plagues and pestilence reminded them plenty. Many people didn't make it out of childhood. The church members who had committed the big sins, that's who Lent was for. The murderers, the apostates, they would be set aside from the whole congregation for the entire season of Lent and then returned to the fold at Easter. According to Dr. Tim O'Malley of Notre Dame University, that's how Lent became a penitential season. First for murderers and fornicators, and by the 6th century, Lent opened and Lent softened a bit, and then the whole community practiced some form of penitence. We often say, remember you are dust, and from dust you shall return. These words were intended to sound scary to the early church. But once the zeitgeist got a hold of these words, they changed meaning, bringing a kind of welcome honesty, says theologian Ben Stewart. The welcome honesty that this life is plan A. That we are mortal creatures, rightly returning to the earth, and that our culture actually doesn't give us that message often enough. The imposition of ashes is a religious ritual in which we encounter something akin to a near-death experience, an encounter with mortality meant for old and young alike. This is what anchors us in this world. This is what is true. Therefore, dust creatures, our mortality is not a curse. It's an opportunity. Actually, it's our one opportunity to live out loud in this world. Tonight, we enter a Christian period of recalibration. And it just feels fitting that this Lent at Calvary, we are choosing to journey not only towards the cross, but towards joy. Because the world, have you noticed, it's lacking joy. People at every turn seem perched and ready to steal your joy. The world, must say it's not just me. This world must learn to dance again before we eat ourselves alive. So we start right here and right now with who we can start with, ourselves. And we begin walking together toward the cross, knowing that those who sow with tears will reap with joy, that God will transform our mourning into dancing. Our conversation partners this year are none other than the Dalai Lama and Archbishop Desmond Tutu. Each worship service, alongside the appointed Bible reading of the day, we will examine one of the 8 pillars of joy, as outlined in the Book of Joy I showed you earlier. You'll hear those 8 pillars read aloud shortly. Some of the pillars are noted in tonight's liturgy, such as the call to practice humility, the call to practice humor, the call to practice gratitude. Speaking of gratitude, it's a special night, but I need to tell you a story first. A teenage young man came out to his family telling them, "I'm gay." One of nine children, his father and brothers turned on him. He, who would not conform to the tradition of machismo in their military family, he leaves home in order to be honest about who he is, and years pass. So much struggle, building strength. He joins a caravan headed out of Guatemala. He leaves his home and he says goodbye. And he finds, finally, an immigrant shelter in Tijuana, Mexico, that is especially kind to LGBT people. One day, a group of pasty-faced Northern California Presbyterians show up for a visit. He shares his story and how he wants to live in safety, how he wants to be free, and how he has heard of a place, California, where the state motto includes equality. Amid laughter, we cry tears. All he has been through, how strong he has grown, how much danger the people, even in that shelter, still live in. Only last week, a young trans woman from Honduras was beaten for the third time. She's had to leave the shelter to go into hiding. Her name is Katerina, and she needs our prayers. But here, in San Francisco, on this very night, that same young man has come to the same Presbyterian church. And here, tonight, he celebrates 4 weeks of living in San Francisco. In every sense, Peter, you walk the faith that recalibrates us in this world. It brings him closer to God and closer to who God created him to be. He turned from the violence of the past and now dances towards the transformation of the future. Esta iglesia te ama. Te da la bienvenida como miembro de la familia y no estás solo. This church loves you, welcomes you as a member of the family, and you are not alone. Gracias a Dios por ti, Peter. Thank God for you, Peter. This Sunday, like Peter, Jesus heads out on his own. No friends, no family, no disciples, no food, no water, no nothing. Jesus comes out to the wilderness. The corresponding pillar of joy this Sunday is perspective, seeing this life from a God's eye view, remembering that we are here but for a brief day, and seizing every moment as precious. Thank you, God, you have turned our mourning into dancing. You have taken off our sackcloth and clothed us with joy, so that our souls may praise you and never be silent, and we will give you thanks forever. Amen.
during this prayer, you'll be invited to lift up the names, the people, and the circumstances of those who are heavy on your hearts tonight. When invited, please feel free to name those out loud, preferably out loud. You may also do so in the quietness of your heart. Let us pray. Holy One, our ancestors in faith use ashes as a sign of our repentance, a symbol of the uncertainty and fragility of human life. Like them, we have tasted the ashes of hopelessness. We have walked through the ashes of our loss and pain. We have stood in the ashes of our brokenness. And so we pray now, lifting up in our hearts and with our voices, those who are mourning, those who are filled with sorrow, those who feel a heavy weight of ashes on their lives and hearts tonight. Hear us now as we name them with our voices and in our hearts.
TJ Michael Garza.
Jonathan. Chuck Melissa.
Jane.
Ted Wells.
Friends of Peggy.
The suffering in Syria.
Timothy.
AC Laws.
Michael Reed. Our nation, Donald Trump, the victims of the coronavirus.
God, we know that you hear our prayers, those spoken aloud, those whispered and lingering on our lips, and those buried deep within our hearts. Lord, we believe, help our unbelief. For out of the dust of creation, you formed us, breathed into us, and gave us life. You call us out of our brokenness and solitude into a life of community and new possibility. We give you thanks that even as we bear the mark of ashes and the dust of humanity, we are invited to experience your ruach, your breath, wind, spirit that brings us life. And so tonight, we also name our hopes, our joys, and our prayers of thanksgiving, lifting them up to you in our hearts and with our voices.
For Beatrice, the state of the community.
For the deacons, the new members and the young people of the church and the children.
This baby hiccuping inside of me. God, on this year's Lenten journey, we remember that you promised to take our sorrow and turn it into joy, to turn our mourning into dancing. And so with the confidence of your beloved children, we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us, saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power.
If you set out and say, I want to be happy, clenching your teeth with determination, this is the quickest way of missing the bus. It is time to delve deeper into the qualities of mind and heart that we need to cultivate to catch that bus. I will now share with you the 8 positive qualities that allow us to experience more joy. 4 are qualities of the mind: perspective, humility, humor, acceptance. And 4 are qualities of the heart: forgiveness, gratitude, compassion, and generosity. Joy and happiness are byproducts. Amen.
At Calvary, all are welcome to participate in this symbolic action. Regardless of spiritual affiliation, non-affiliation, or baptismal status. Please approach one of the stations here in front of the sanctuary. And those of you with mobility concerns may receive the imposition of ashes while seated. Raise your hand and I will come to you. You may receive the ashes on the forehead or on the back of your hand. And those who are not desiring a cross of ashes may request a spiral instead. You are invited to come down the center aisle and then move in a clockwise direction down this other aisle. There will be 3 stations in front, and choose the one that is open to you. Thank you. Joanne will have forms, or any staff member can help you do that. Also, if you would like to be on our mailing list, you may get on that also. Friends, receive these words of Jesus. Peace I give to you. My peace I leave with you, which is not the kind of peace the world can give. So let not your heart be troubled, and do not be afraid, for the blessings of God, Creator, Christ, and Holy Spirit, these three, they go with you this day and every day and all the way to the cross, all the way to the transformation dance of Easter. And let the church say,
Amen.
And it is so. Peace be with you.
And also with you.
As we leave, let us exchange signs of peace.
Peace be with you.